Understanding Chronic Pancreatitis and Nutrition. Chronic pancreatitis is a long-term, irreversible inflammatory disease that causes progressive replacement of normal pancreatic tissue into scar tissue. It can be caused by smoking, excessive use of alcohol, genetic mutations, some autoimmune diseases, a severe episode of pancreatitis, or recurrent pancreatitis, among others. It can also run in families. Sometimes the cause is never discovered. As the disease progresses over time, your pancreas becomes more inflamed and damaged. It can lose its ability to produce essential enzymes needed for your body's normal nutritional process to break down foods. Without these essential enzymes, your body may have trouble digesting food and absorbing nutrients. The pancreas also makes hormones such as insulin, which is crucial for body sugar control. A small group of patients with chronic pancreatitis are at risk of developing diabetes. Some diseases make it hard for your body to digest food properly. Maldigestion is the term used for impaired digestion. Malabsorption, on the other hand, is the term used when food is poorly absorbed. The body only absorbs and digests small amounts of food. This prevents the body from absorbing key nutrients. Both maldigestion and malabsorption can lead to malnutrition. People with chronic pancreatitis develop maldigestion and malabsorption because they don't produce enough enzymes to digest food. This is called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency. People with chronic pancreatitis who are malnourished often lose fat and muscle that leads to weight loss. You don't have to be thin to be malnourished, though. People who are normal body weight range or overweight can also be malnourished, no matter how much food they consume. It all depends on how nutritious the food is and how well their body digests and absorbs the nutrients. If you're malnourished, you might feel tired, weak, or have a lack of energy. Cuts or scrapes might take longer than usual to heal. Malnourishment affects how well your immune system works and how your body's cells can repair or rebuild themselves. As chronic pancreatitis progresses, another symptom that occurs is fatty, foul-smelling stool. This is called steatorrhea. If you notice bulky, pale, greasy, and foul-smelling stool when you move your bowels, this is steatorrhea. The fatty stool is caused by your body's inability to produce pancreatic lipase, so fat can't be absorbed. Steatorrhea is considered to be a late-stage symptom of chronic pancreatitis, where a significant amount of the pancreas has been damaged. People with chronic pancreatitis should have a nutritional assessment and follow-up by a registered dietitian. Dietitians use nutritional screening tools to assess if people are getting enough nutrients from their diet. Typically, a dietitian will measure your height and weight to determine your body mass index. The dietitian also needs to know if you have recently lost weight unintentionally, if your appetite is less than usual, and if you show signs of serious illness. During your first visit with a dietitian, you may be asked to keep a journal of what you eat over the course of a few days. The dietitian needs an idea of what your diet is like, how often you eat, and when you eat. Once that is established, the dietitian will look for other clues about your nutritional health, such as your activity level. Your medical history and test reports are also full of information for your dietitian to work with. Blood tests can tell if you're lacking vitamins and minerals, stool tests can show if your body is losing fat, and other tests can show things like how strong your bones are. Once your dietitian has a good idea about your nutritional status, it's time for the two of you to work as a team to make plans that incorporate good nutrition. Your dietitian will monitor your progress to see how well your nutrition changes are helping your body. And if needed, you both can tweak your diet to see if you can make further improvements. If you have exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, pancreatic enzyme replacement therapy will be prescribed by your doctor. Follow-up is important because people with chronic pancreatitis are at risk for developing complications, such as diabetes. Other complications include osteoporosis or thinning bones and pancreatic cancer. A good diet, good hydration, nutritional supplements, and, when indicated, pancreatic enzymes are the major parts in the effort to manage nutrition in chronic pancreatitis. However, people with the disease may also need to make some lifestyle changes. One of the most important is to stop drinking alcohol and smoking cigarettes. If they have trouble doing so on their own, there are programs that can help.